हेलो व्यूअर्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल लाइफ्स कैलकुलेशंस। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस विद यू द टॉपिक टू फाइंड द मीडियन ऑफ ए ग्रुप्ड डाटा बाय ड्राइंग एन ऑजीव फ्रॉम आईसीएसई मैथ्स क्लास 10 सिलेबस। दिस इज चैप्टर नंबर 24 इन आईसीएसई मैथ्स, राइट? सो स्टूडेंट्स, वेन एवर वी हैव टू फाइंड द मीडियन ऑफ अ ग्रुप्ड डाटा, रिमेंबर ऑलवेज class interval will be given to us like this and frequency will be given to us. I have taken up one question in which I will be explaining how to find the median. This is very clearly a grouped data, okay, where class intervals are given 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 30, 30 to 40 and 40 to 50. In front of each class intervals, we are also given the frequency, right? Now, here one thing very important we have to see, that this data means the class intervals given are very much continuous. Okay, suppose they are discontinuous. Discontinuous means the upper limit of the first and the lower limit of the next do not match. Okay, if they do not match like this, then we have to make it continuous. That process extra one or two steps we have to add here, right? So if you don't know, otherwise I have discussed in one of my previous videos. If you do not know, I will again remind you, and please tell me about that. Okay, now our process here is to find the median of grouped data. For that, from the frequency we have to write the cumulative frequency. Okay, cumulative frequency, first one remains the 4 only, second one is simply 4 plus 9 is equal to 13, then 13 plus 15 would give me 28, and 18 plus 14 will give me 42, and 42 plus 8 is 50. Cumulative frequency for 10th class is not a new thing, because in 9th class you have done and seen all about this. Okay, so it is simply the sum total of all the frequencies. If I have to check up to 15, so up to 15 it is the sum total of all the frequencies, that is why it is a 28. Students, after finding the cumulative frequency, now the next process, first step was to find cumulative frequency. Second step is to draw a ogive. Okay, and whenever we draw something, we always need a graph paper. Most important thing, to draw an ogive. You speak it as, sometimes we speak it as ogive also, ogive also, both the things are correct. Okay, now in order to draw ogive, we must know what to be taken towards x-axis, what to be taken towards y-axis, okay, and what points to be plotted there. Okay, so before actually I start drawing, I will tell you which points to be plotted against what, right? So students, remember, in order to draw a ogive, always take class intervals towards x-axis, right, and cumulative frequency towards y-axis. Once this has been done, x-axis, y-axis has been plotted, then we will see which points to be taken. So remember, always to take upper limit of each class interval will be plotted against the cumulative frequency corresponding to that. Okay, from this class interval, suppose, just see, I'm taking one example. From first example, first class interval 0 to 10, which one is its upper limit? Its upper limit is 10. Right, and against that upper limit or the class interval, which one is the cumulative frequency? That is 4. So our first point will be 10, 4. Second point, what will be? It will be upper limit is 20 and the cumulative frequency is 13. Next point would be, very clearly, it would be 30 comma 28, and next to that point will be 40 comma 42, and next to that will be 50 comma 50. Okay, these points are to be plotted in order to draw the ogive, right? And what to be taken x-axis, on x-axis, y-axis, I've already told to you. Okay, students, once this setting, within 1 or 1.5 minute, you will actually, I would advise you always to form the coordinates of the points like this. Then there is no chance that you are none of the points, there is not a single chance that your points may go wrong. Otherwise, in a hurry, there is a chance that you may see wrong point and you may draw it wrongly. Otherwise, but if properly made up the coordinates like this, then there is a less chance. And you very well know in 10th class that what is the meaning of this ordered pair 10, 4. 10, 4 means 10 towards x-axis and 4 towards y-axis. Now, after this, Once all this has been done, we will draw an ajeev, and now for that we need a graph sheet. I have plotted on graph sheet that I am going to tell you later. Now students, I have drawn x-axis and y-axis here. I have tried to show a graph paper on this plane only, okay, and later I will tell you the actual graph sheet where I have actually drawn this ajeev, right? So towards x-axis, this is the class interval. Towards y-axis, this is the cumulative frequency. And because the class interval was 0 to 10, 10 to 20, so I have very comfortably taken the scale, okay? And remember not to forget to write the scale. Towards x-axis, what is that? 1 unit. Our 1 centimeter is equal to 10 unit, okay? And same, it is for both x-axis and y-axis, right? Cumulative frequency minimum was 4 and maximum was 50. So comfortably I have taken 1 unit is equal to 10 parts, right? So that is why everywhere I have taken on both the axes 1 centimeter is equal to 10 units, right? Now we will start actually plotting the points in order to draw the ajeev. So first is 10, 4, okay? So 10 on x-axis and 4 on y-axis, this point will come out to be somewhere here. Okay, this is not the exact location, but in order to show. And students, this is the point we have plotted, and around that don't forget to draw an empty circle, and don't forget also to write the location like this. Very much important. This is our first point. Second point to be plotted is 20 13, 20 on x-axis and 13 on y-axis, right? So 13 will be, because exactly mid here will be 15, and just below this will be our 13, okay? So when you are drawing actually on the graph sheet, then there will not be much a problem. And this is our second point. And the third point is 30, 28, 30 on x-axis and 28 against 30 here, and 28 around here, we will have 30, 28 on y-axis. Next point to be plotted is 40, 42. 40 on x-axis and 42 just above 40 will be our 42. Okay, so this is our point. And again, see, I am writing the ordered pair with the location of the point only, and drawing an empty circle also. Last is 50, 50. So 50, 50 will be exactly here. Both are already shown. Okay, so now comes the most important part of joining all these points with the help of a free hand. Okay, students, remember not to join all these points, means inside what I have drawn, not to join all these points with the help of scale, but simply to join them with the help of a free hand only, right? Okay, so let us try here. Okay, like this only. Okay, so a little here between 20 13 to 30 28, a little dip has come. It should not be there. Okay, and then once this part we have done, then important thing is to join it, this curve. We cannot leave it hanging like this, so we need to join it with x-axis. And where to join? Always, students, see, on the class interval side, where to join? We will be joining it with the lower limit of the first class interval, and that is 0. Okay, so on x-axis we will give it a start like this. We will join it with the x-axis like this. Okay students, so this is our ajeev. Now with the help of ajeev, we need to find what is the median. Okay, so for that we need to write the formula, and that formula, because median is the middlemost value, so a little space I will make use here only, so that everything I am able to show on this screen, right? So listen, we know that median is what? Middlemost value. It is simply n by 2. What is n? N is our 50. The last cumulative frequency is always the n. So 50 divided by 2 means this will come out to be 25. Now students, here comes the most important part of our question, the process to find actually the median, right? So I will not write it median equal to. This is the process to find median. So 25 this is the 25. 25 we have to see in the cumulative frequency. Cumulative frequency is on y-axis. Okay, so where will our 25 lie? See very carefully. Our 25 will lie on this y-axis here. Just see exactly here. Please try to see. Okay, this is our 25. This answer, listen very carefully. This answer 25 we are going to find or mark on y-axis in the cumulative frequency. Now is the most important part. From this we will be drawing from 25, draw a horizontal line. Draw a horizontal line on your curve with the help of scale. Now this line will be with the help of a scale only. Now from this point where our curve is meeting this horizontal line, we will draw a vertical line on x-axis, on x-axis like this. Okay, and now is the point where we wanted to reach, because this point where this line, vertical line, meets our x-axis is the answer of the median. Students, this point you are going to read from the scale. Okay, and I will just tell you, when I actually drew on the graph, this paper, this point is coming out to be 28, right? So what is the answer of our median? Median is 28. Median will always be seen on the x-axis side. So this answer is 28. Okay, so students, this was all about the drawing of ajeev in order to find the median of a grouped data. Now I will actually show you where I have drawn ajeev on the graph copy, right? And same thing the way I have drawn here and done the calculation, exactly same thing I have repeated here. Okay, so students, if you like the video, please do subscribe to my channel. Forget to press the bell icon so that I can send you directly my next videos on the same topic also. Thank you very much for watching.